This is my son. Two weeks ago yesterday, he overdosed. Now some of you are probably thinking that that woman's nuts. She brought her son's ashes for the world to see. This is how real and serious this problem is. And this is my way of trying to get your attention. My son had plans. He went to rehab. He had been clean since November 5th. And he was planning on becoming an alcohol and drug counselor. But he got sick. He developed pancreatitis. And he had to go to the emergency room. In the emergency room, they gave him morphine for pain. Pancreatitis is extremely painful. He was transferred to Syracuse, where he, once they got his blood levels where they needed to be, they did gallbladder surgery. He basically had a gallstone blocking his pancreas. While he was there, before and after surgery, they gave him more opiates. When he came home from the hospital and stayed with us for a week after surgery, he came home with a prescription for oxycodone. And the nurse said to me in the hospital, "You're going to have to really keep an eye on him when he goes home. If they send him home with painkillers." Now, my son was always very forward and very honest about his problems and very proud to be clean and having gone through rehab. They knew in the hospital, he told them. I sat there and I thought, when they said they were going to give him morphine, I thought, "Whoa, you're kidding me." But then I said, "They're the experts." Well, he came home with 4 days of painkiller, which I monitored very closely, and he did not abuse those painkillers. And I said to him Friday, he was already out of painkillers, I said, "Geez, but I don't know. This has me worried. I'm afraid you're going to go through withdrawal again." And he said, "Yeah, Mom, I know, but it can't be as bad as the last time." Well, he went home Sunday night, and I got a phone call about 3 o'clock Tuesday morning that the ambulance was at his house to take him to the emergency. So I went flying over here to Longville. And as I got out of my car, I thought, you want to talk about a war on drugs? You have not seen a war on drugs. And where that thought came from, I have no idea. But I believe it was a message that I need to do this. And I need to educate people as much as I am able. And then I ran into the emergency room where they were doing CPR on my son and were not able to bring him back. So, some of you may have seen my Facebook posts with this bag of ashes. That post has been shared 5,000 times. The thing about an addict is, and my son would tell me this, even while he was clean, that it was an everyday battle. It was something that he was going to have to fight with for the rest of his life. everybody was ready. I believe that you, in order for a good outcome in rehab, I believe that person has to have it in their mind and heart that it's going to work. I really don't know any statistics on this, but my son said to me, "Mom, I really think that the reason why this worked for me this time is because I wanted it so badly." He had it for a while. But I think everybody needs to realize that actually there's no stigma. There is, but there shouldn't be. People look at addicts, some people when they first think addict, they think somebody maybe that's homeless, or I don't know, just is so absolutely down and out, has nothing going for them. But do you know in this room right now, you could actually be sitting, the person beside you could be an addict. There's no certain class of people that becomes an addict. It can be anyone. Anyone. We need compassion. Addicts should not be treated any differently than anyone else. They need love. They need support. Withholding love is not going to be the answer. I remember some time ago, my son and I had a very good relationship. I remember the day that he said to me, I was sitting at the kitchen table and he was standing by the counter. And he said to me, "Mom, I've got to tell you, I snorted a little bit of heroin." And I began to cry. And I said, "Oh, bud, I don't want you to die." And in typical Trent fashion, I got a pat on the back and he said, "Don't worry, Mom, I'm going to be okay." Well, he wasn't. But my message really is we need to come together. We're a community. I've been invited to, I never was really much of a Facebook person, but I have become one. I was invited to a group for addicts, and it's a close group. There's 74,000 members. These are people that may still be in active addiction. They may have been clean for 5 days. They may have been clean for 5 years or even longer. But what this group has been for these people is support. Now, in my mind, I think that's good, but where's the support from your community? Where's the hugs? Where's the love? Inside each one of us, we have a beating heart, so do they. And that's really what people need. I don't know, but I'm going to share my story. I was hoping I'd do a good job, but